Glycogen is the main storage form of glucose in our body, and the major sites of glycogen production are liver and muscle tissues. Exactly these two tissues store the highest amount of glycogen in our body. Basically, glycogen is a huge amount of glucose molecules that are connected together mostly in a linear fashion, and this connection occurs by alpha-1-4 glycosidic bonds. To explain this, it's glucose molecule. As we know, glucose molecule has 6 carbons. And there is the second glucose molecule. Most of glucose molecules in the glycogen structure are connected with each other by the first and the fourth carbons. And because this bond is created between the first and the fourth carbons, this bond called alpha-1-4 glycosidic bond. Obviously, glycogen cannot store huge amount of glucose molecules just in one line. So glycogen has branches. Branches are created by connection of additional glucose molecule to one of the glucose molecules in this linear structure. But important that to create branch, these glucose molecules has to be binded by alpha-1-6 glycosidic bond. And the specific feature of alpha-1-6 glycosidic bond is that this bond binds glucose in a vertical fashion. To explain this, there is third glucose molecule, and to create branch, this glucose molecule has to be connected to glucose molecule in a vertical fashion. And the way to do this is that this glucose molecule with the first carbon binds to the sixth carbon of glucose in a linear structure. As a result, water released and the alpha-1-6 glycosidic bond is formed. And now these branches can be elongated by adding of additional glucose molecules by a usual 1-4 glycosidic bonds. As we see, this creates a brand new line of glucose molecules in a glycogen structure. So the purpose of these vertical bonds is that these vertical branches permits glycogen to store more glucose molecules. Also very important that glycogen stores in both muscle tissue and liver tissue are limited, because glycogen is not the optimal storage material. Generally, we have two major storage materials, it's glycogen and triacylglycerols. Basically, as we see, glycogen is the assembly of glucose molecules. And the major problem with glucose is that glucose has a lot of hydroxy groups, and these hydroxy groups attract water. So because glucose is highly hydrophilic molecule, when liver tissue, for example, stores glucose, with glucose, liver tissue also stores a lot of water. And the major problem here is that with increasing amount of water, the size of the liver increase. So the higher the amount of glycogen in the liver tissue, the higher the amount of water, so the bigger becomes the mass and the size of the liver tissue. In contrast to glycogen, triacylglycerols are totally hydrophobic, because triacylglycerols is basically glycerol with 3 fatty acids. So triacylglycerols do not attract water at all. And because of this, when liver stores triacylglycerols, liver stores just glycerol and fatty acids, without any water nearby. Exactly this feature makes triacylglycerols very compact substances to store. So glycogen is not the optimal storage material, because it takes a lot of space to store glycogen in the tissue. And because of that, glycogen stores in our body are very limited.